Today, I'll help your maps go from looking like this to this. So, let's get building. First, I like to start off by creating a nice big plane so I have somewhere to work on, making sure I also add some color and texture. Adding this is to help visualize what size I want the map to be and how dense the details should be. After finishing the plane, I move on to creating these hilly barriers that will circle around the plane I made. As I do this, I try to use the textures that will fit the same theme and mix nicely with each other. I like to add small details to these grass tops so they don't look so plain into each other. I usually make around 3 to 5 different barriers that have different grass tops and sizes to keep everything looking unique, like you see in this time lapse. After creating the grass top variants, I duplicate them and paste them onto the plane I made not too long ago. This is where I decided that there needs to be some more detail in these barriers, and I duplicated them so they are 2 times the original height, which is good since they're a bit too short for my liking anyway. I then proceeded to duplicating the dirt barriers to trap the player inside, making them act sort of as a mountain range. Once that was done, I went in and made sure they are all properly scaled without any glitches or pockets the player can see through. The next step was to add a path throughout the map, and this was done using these small rectangular patches of dirt and a plugin that will be linked in the description below. I try to make the path look natural and make the path squiggle around the place while branching out into different directions. To fill the map, I needed to make some foliage, so I made trees, starting out with the trunk of the tree, then texturing and coloring it to match the color palette. Next, I worked on making some leaves using some large, thin parts and rotating them around the tree, getting smaller the higher on the tree they were, as this short time lapse shows. I wanted to make the trees a little more dense, so I doubled the amount of leaves they had, and that worked out fine. All I had to do from here was copy and paste the trees around the map and made each one have a different height and rotation to keep things looking unique. After getting all the trees in place, I started working on some rocks, which was just a bunch of cubes placed in a group that had a rock texture. And to make them look better, I put some effort into rotating each cube, which made it look really good. I proceeded to make a few different rock models, since the same rock model over and over again would be very repetitive. Once that was done, I pasted them all over the map and rotated them. Once those rocks were in place, I started working on some rocky cave-like structures that will go well with the ends of the pass, so they don't seem like they go straight into a wall. It blended in well, and I added black parts in the middle so it appears to be too dark to see what's inside. Going on, I made some tall grass using the same plugin that was used for the pass earlier. I kept the same texture, except turned the grass's color to be green. After the model was done, I made it a little bit bigger and pasted it around the forest floor. This next part is a bit tricky, but I worked with some negated and union parts to make it work, and what you see me making is a small river that flows across the map, and it ended up looking really nice. After the river was complete, I made these bridges that go across the river that I just made. I made some support beams, then put some wooden parts across the support beams, proceeding to rotate them and scaling them to make each one unique. I did the same thing with the other path that the river intercepts. Now that all the structure's done, I added some custom lighting, which is crucial to make your map look good. And now that I'm done, here are the results.